All right, this was the Delhi Times Fashion Week Day 1, and we witnessed magic on the ramp, thanks to, of course, the very, very talented and everyone's favorite Reena Dhaka and our absolutely gorgeous showstopper, Gayatri Bhardwaj. Congratulations for yet another splendid show. How do you feel, Reena?
Well, I feel like one more, like next, yes. Like this is done. This baby is ready for the... Yeah. It's launched,
correct,
and now
correct.
For the next one, and the models were beautiful. It was really nice, and Gayatri's been fabulous,
yes.
And I'm really grateful for this chance because I got it because I'm a mentor to an institute, actually,
correct.
To the students of JD.
Yes.
And so to close this kind of a show is very special. I've never done such a thing before.
Absolutely. Now, of course, we couldn't take our eyes off each and every garment, you know, the saris, even her outfit. Would you like to throw some light on what was behind Reena Dhaka's mind while she was designing?
So the light is what was behind my mind, as you can evidently see. So I always imagine women in saris to be, or in Indian outfits, to be fairy-like, dream-like, to have something which is like when person watches them, they leave a memory in your eyes, which I feel are like computers. So it's like kind of a wispy collection, like a tale of petals, of gentleness, of romance, yet it's so subtle in its color and impact and light, something which I feel is important as a woman, because... I mean, to get in and out of cars is also a part of the
yes.
dressing up. So if you get a balloon dress, which is really avant-garde,
yes.
you don't have a car. That's why if you see some of these showstoppers yes. or the actors at the car, Croisette in
yes.
Cannes, they have special cars.
I know, they're huge. They come in trucks.
Yeah, and they must be so thrilled when they're off with the... with the garment. So I think what is a kind of modernity is also about recreating elegance and simplicity. So I'm not trying to take away from festive season. I'm not trying to take away from embroideries and craft. But I also try to put in the story of sheer and lightness.
Absolutely. How did you feel, Gayatri? She's talking about sheer and being light and...
yeah, I was just going to say how light my outfit is right now. It's super flowy and it was a dream to walk the ramp for someone like ma'am.
Oh,
and yeah, dreams do come true.
And you looked very comfortable walking on the ramp, so I'm sure...
I've done this a lot now,
yeah.
So I'm used to it. But you always have nerves. You always feel nervous before you go on stage.
True.
But it was an absolute pleasure. And also about this garment, like it's so lightweight, it's so flowy.
True.
And not only mine, I think I saw all the models backstage. They were all a dream to look at.
Absolutely,
so
I agree with you.
Yeah.
Reena, tell me something. There are so many new designers coming up.
Yeah.
How do you, what tips would you give them to cope up with this pressure, you know, because I'm sure like you are of course a mentor too. How did you manage?
So the students in the institute are brilliant.
Yeah.
You know, what is nice is to see their ideas
mm-hmm.
because it's their world. They're the millennials anyway.
Yeah. Yeah.
And how they perceive the same world we were once in.
Mm-hmm.
So I really think that the old and the new must get together. And the markets are huge.
Mm-hmm.
And there is room for everyone as long as one can go through or tide over the...
Yes.
There is struggle, of course. There's no doubt about it. But if one can tide over the, you know, the stepping stones,
true.
there are always going to be new players. There will always be the new Gayatris, the new Miss Indias. And the same way
yes.
in fashion, there'll
yes.
always be the next Sabyasachis or
true.
The Aki Narulas
yes.
or the, I don't remember, but the guys who get all the awards.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
the recent Indian girl bodice who
yes.
also got a... like a Vogue International Award.
Absolutely.
So we'll always have those stars.
That's nice.
And Delhi's winter's coming, and would you like to throw some light on what the millennials should keep in mind while dressing themselves up?
Well, they can look sexy like I just showed them in a
yeah.
sari, because the millennials have those great backs.
Yeah.
And even the sheer sharara we did with the lace, but
yeah.
it's not like fully transparent.
Yeah.
And so I think millennials need to look classy, elegant, keep in a kind of a minimalism,
yeah.
which is not so minimalistic in terms of getting dressed
yes.
but or getting the clothes ready. But in appearance, it's minimal and very effective.
Very effective.
Tell me, Gayatri, what is your winter look, since of course you're also from Delhi?
Most importantly, I think right now the festive season's coming up, so I'm very excited to don my Indian outfits.
Lovely.
And those jhumkas with my, I want to plan my Diwali lookbook very
wow.
soon, because I do like going out and meeting my friends, playing cards.
Correct.
So, yeah, and talking about winter, I think I'm more about layering and lots of, I love color in the winter because
yeah.
it's so gloomy
yeah,
and so like cold, so I like breaking the monotony with different bright colors. And also, as she said, that monotones and simplicity, like being minimalistic
yeah.
is underrated, I feel.
Yeah.
But I think that's most effective, and
absolutely.
that speaks volumes about your style.
True, that's very, very
true. Thank you so much for
Thank
talking
you.
To us, and congratulations for yet another beautiful and magical
Thank
show.
You.
Thank you, you're absolutely
Thank you.
Lovely. Thanks.